Hey guys, welcome. I'm Profitz from Profitz.tv. This is another video series in my gold making series, talking about this time TradeSkillMaster version 3. You heard it, TradeSkillMaster version 3. At the time of this video recording, which is as of today, it is actually still in closed beta. Today is the 25th of May. It's Monday afternoon, 4:19 p.m. There is belief, or is rumor, that you can expect TradeSkillMaster version 3 to be in open beta within a month or a soonish. Open parentheses, close parentheses. So we'll see what happens, but there's a lot of exciting things that have been happening in TradeSkillMaster version 3, guys. If you guys thought TradeSkillMaster 2 was great, TradeSkillMaster 3 is phenomenal. So in this video, we're just going to be talking about the UI changes. It's going to be a quick video, but I just want to highlight some of the differences. Just when you thought that you got familiar with version 2, you will now have to become familiar with version 3 and change some things around a little bit. And they did the changes basically for the reason of consolidating it and making it more optimized, or actually more user-friendly once you see the actual changes. So let me turn down my volume just a little bit because I am in winter spring. I tried to select an auction house that wasn't too populated. So I'm going to turn down my volume pretty far down. And let's get started here. So version 2, if you remember TradeSkillMaster, here it is. And you notice it had separate modules and operations broken out. It had tooltips broken out. This is the info, which had options and profiles managed with your custom prices. You're all familiar with this screen. And then it had a bunch of different options like accounting. It had some additions. It had destroying if you wanted to. It had additional modules like price reply if you're talking about that, warehousing and so forth. So you notice there's a lot of actual modules, features up on top. So what they did is they now consolidated the use of these right here. So let's bring this window down. And you can see right away that it's optimized. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 instead of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, and then 11. Albeit price reply is not an official module, but as you can see, if you installed multiple modules, it can get kind of tight at the top of the screen, which making it seem more complex. So in TradeSkillMaster 3, ladies and gentlemen, it is optimized. So as you can see in the main screen here, as soon as you come in, they actually added a couple cool tabs that I'm going to talk about as well right off the bat. One of those is, notice options, no longer here. Notice profiles, no longer here. Custom prices is still there. It doesn't mean that you're going to lose options and profiles, but notice where they put them. We'll talk about that in a couple of minutes. So talking about the main page, when you come in, we are in version 3, and this is Rev 119, what is currently in, or Build 119, however you want to talk about it. And then notice now they put in, this is options and core features, and then these are module features, just like in version 2. Where this was just options and modules over here, they put in core features built into it as well. So let's take a look. Inventory viewer. This is kind of neat. So it kind of shows you at a glance, based upon your characters, your guilds, based upon your custom price source that you want to do, it evaluates, which is pretty slick, the total amount of your gold worth in based upon this price source. So it goes through all of your items, all of your bags, all of your banks, and consolidates everything, and it basically gives spits out a number and saying, all right, here's your inventory total value, again, based upon this price source. And as you guys know, you can go to TradeSkillMaster.com and check out their custom price sources, which include DB Market, which include WoW Auction, Regional Market, On Demand Journal, blah, blah, blah. You can do anything you want with the price source, percentages, and so forth. So that's kind of cool. The next cool feature, as you guys know, TradeSkillMaster is very powerful in its ability to be able to upload, not upload, but post, bulk buy, bulk cancel, bulk destroy. You can do pretty much everything by macroing or keybinding the wheel mouse to be able to do these functions. So right away it's saying, all right, let's take advantage of this. And by default, notice it's all checked. Doesn't mean it's set. You actually have to click this button still, like in version 2. And notice up and down, and then your choice of control key or modifier key, whether you want control, alt, and shift. I personally just use control. Keep it default. All you do is come down here, click this button, and you're good to go. And then that actually key bound your ability to be able to do these functions right here. If perchance you do not want to have one of them, all you need to do is uncheck the box and bind it to your scroll wheel again just by pressing this button. Very simple. Custom prices, if you're one of those fanatics that like custom prices and the use of 35 parentheses and so forth in your price sources, this allows you to do pretty much anything that you can think of, which will suit your fancy. I'm not going to really get into custom prices because personally I don't use them. So the next one is options. So notice on the options screen, this has changed a lot. So what we were talking about before with module operations and tooltips are now condensed into this feature called options, which is cool because you no longer have to click on separate buttons at the top or command centers to be able to get into your features. All of your actual tab features and functions are right here right now. So accounting, this is all your accounting settings. Still the same, still the ability to be able to do quite a bit of functionality within it. Actually, everything when you migrate over from TradeSkillMaster version 2 to version 3, your operations, your groups, your structures, and so forth will be migrated over automatically. You will have to reset up some of the actual profile sharing and so forth like that, syncs between multiple accounts, but that's easily to set up. Everything else should be synced pretty decently without any issue. So notice you have some checkboxes, display gray items and sales. You can track sales and purchases. You can track per item, per total value. Prompt when recording trades, or you know when you trade, do you want it to prompt to actually record the information or not through an actual trade window? And then your purging down here, which is very important. How often do you want to keep the information for your data history? I keep 45 days, which is pretty decent. You don't have to do that. You can go down as low as 30 and as high as 90. Just make sure that your disk space is sufficient to be able to handle that. And then Auction DB, which used to be separate, is now right here as well. Show auction tab data, reload required. And then it shows the actual information of when it was last updated. The auction information is actually pretty decent as well. Notice this is the first one now that we're getting to that actually puts sound capabilities established to some of the actual functions. So notice this is going to be a sound. This is going to be a sound-rich TSM version 3, which means you can apply sound to a lot of things that will give you audible alerts when you're done. For instance, when your scan completes, do you want an audible alert? The audible alerts are in a drop-down, and then these are your ones available to you. And basically, they sound like this. So here's the auction window close. Is an auction window open. Let me make sure you can actually hear that. Let me turn my sound back up. We'll make this into our headphones. And we'll make our sound will be, we want to turn it up just a little bit. So you can hear these. And we're getting there. And we're getting there. And my sound went out. Imagine that. Imagine that in a video where you're trying to actually edit stuff, your sound actually goes out. What the hell is going on here? My Windows is blowing up. My Windows is freaking blowing up. All right, let's check this one more time, and then if not, we're just going to move forward with it. Sound was working, but you never know what's going to happen. Headphones. 64 sound. There we go. Let's crank these up. That was the problem. They're actually too low. All right. So just to show you some of the sound now, going back to this real quick. Underneath auctioning, as we're talking, here's an actual close. You're familiar with that? Here's an actual open. Here's an actual reel in. You can have like a fishing sound. Ah, nice. Exploration. Whoa, pretty. And you can do the little player invite accept. Bam. Imagine that when you're rolling in glorious leg plates. You can have the illustrious level up sound. You can have money frame. Oh, yeah, let's hear that again. Okay. Let's go on to map ping. Kind of cool. Quest added. Some of these are kind of loud, but and some of them are actually longer than others, like this one. but you can change it to be anything that you want based upon what you're doing. So if you're waiting for something epic to come up, you can actually attach something that's a little longer to get your attention. Raid warning, ready check. Cash register. Oh, this is our familiar cash register sound. Let me get. Very nice. And you have no sound, then of course auto quest complete. Then you have auto objectives. Then you have unwrap gift. Kind of interesting. So we'll keep this in on a simple, let's go with, do that money frame open. We'll keep it as that. You can round normal prices. You can actually whitelist players. This is something that's sometimes interesting or usable for people who do want to actually not compete against each other in the auction house, but kind of team up with each other. You can actually enter their name here, hyphen, and the actual realm if it is through a connected realm, connected server. Crafting is the same functionality we can do. Pretty much everything that's available in here is available in here. All your price definitions and stuff at the bottom. Not a lot of UI changes here. Destroying, again, is everything that was in the destroying feature up at the top. Now consolidated into the feature down here. Mailing is awesome as well. Delete NPC, delete empty NPC mail, which is a pretty cool feature you could actually do here if you do want to purge your mailboxes and stuff from after you get the items, and they always leave the annoying empty mail behind. You can do that. You can again change the sound if you wanted to once everything's complete for doing your mailbox. Send items individual, restart, all this capability is now built in. You can even do the default, which is cool, almost like the default tab when you're opening up the auction house. Shopping is pretty awesome as well. Notice at the bottom is now sniper features are again built in, but this time with the sound capability again. Very important if you're running multiple accounts and you want to actually check in or tab out to do something else, or if you don't have multiple monitors, you can actually enable a sound. When that sound goes off, you know, the alt tab over or to switch over to that client and buy whatever you need to buy. Vendoring is awesome as well. I'm going to talk about vendoring once we actually talk about the vendoring video that I'll be creating, because there's a lot of cool features coming with the vendoring option. All your tooltips are right here as well. So remember, it was a separate wheel, cogwheel type feature. Now it's actually built in to one main feature right here, so you don't have to worry about that. And then all the additional features are built right in here. This is where all of your tooltips come from. I highly recommend obviously checking them all. It gives you the most of your informational features that you'd actually want to receive in your TradeSkillMaster. The more information you have, the more that you can actually act upon, which is important. Other than that, we'll jump to the next group, which you can also look, all of your profile information is now here instead of it actually being on the first page, first tab. Your profile information has moved. Again, underneath all of the modules, options, everything is here that you'll want to do. All your UI changes. Notice my UI for TradeSkillMaster is colored. It's kind of like a darker crimson red. All your profiles and stuff is doing here. Notice I do a lot of profile information. I typically recommend if you're playing on multiple accounts or multiple realms rather, make sure that you create a specific profile for that realm. Just to make sure if you're adjusting prices, which you should be per realm, that you can do that without any problems. Account syncing, again, this has been enhanced and improved to be able to provide that easy functionality that you can do. And then here's your actual windows where you can do your auction sales. You can get testing sound capabilities for doing that when you actually get auction sales. What do you want it to sound like? You can change those features, your vendor buying features, which you can enable and disable, Twitter integration, which is awesome as well, which we'll talk about in another video. This video we're specifically just talking about high level, the UI. You do have the similar groups as in version 2 that you do in version 3. And notice again, all of them actually have the capabilities of tying auctions, operations, and your operations are pretty much the same. Notice a new one here, vendoring, which we'll talk about. Same thing, TradeSkillMaster version 2 is built on groups, items in those groups. Interesting, in TradeSkillMaster version 3, we will talk specifically about the ability to have no groups and no items in those groups and still interface with the auction house with the feature called Quick Post from Bags. So take a look at that. Look forward to that video once I pull that one out. Should be coming up shortly. So all of your posting information, all your groups and stuff are right here. Pretty much the same information that you can actually see across all of the operations. If you go into operations, then here's your individual sections that you can go down and change based upon your liking. And these are pretty much the same type of setup that you can do. Notice in one of them, you can actually set an actual cap now, which is kind of cool. We'll talk about that in the next video. I don't want to get into that here. But you can actually set max expired in actual groups, which is very, very cool if you actually like maintaining how much you've actually posted and so forth. Whether you want to manage it, whether you want to do something with it, it's pretty cool. So we'll be talking about this max expires feature in another video. So here's all your crafting. You can go through and set all of your functionality and all your features built in right into the actual operations section. Your groups are still the same. Your accounting is also exceptionally put together and optimized as well. So all of your tabs and features are across the top here. We can actually go through and check out your summaries, your player gold, all across the top. Those settings are still enabled and still capable of doing what you love it to do. Crafting is also an awesome thing with cooldowns, crafting tabs at the very top. And then you can have the ability to filter by professions, which are still there. Price sources you can detect. You can actually check what you actually own, what you can craft, make your custom lists just like before. Left click and add them to the queues. Again, we'll talk about that in another video. And then of course you have destroying, which is the same functionality. We can actually do destroying of different types of materials if you do this feature, if you use this feature or not. So that is basically version 3 as of this video revision 119 or 119 of the actual UI. Still accessible from the minimap or accessible through /TSM. That functionality is still the same. So if we look at the UI changes now for the auction house, it is going to look a lot different, guys. So notice when we pull up the actual auction house, the shopping tab, notice that the shopping tab has changed a little bit. You might say a little bit, right? So this was the old TradeSkillMaster version 3 shopping tab. Notice on the side, it's always going to have, based upon what you click on these windows, an extension that comes out to support that tab right here. In version 3, they kind of collapse it all within the main frame here, which is cool. It kind of optimizes your ability to see a smaller UI for TradeSkillMaster and not always have to go over here and deal with overlays or any type of issues like that. So in shopping, now you have everything accessible that you can possibly think of. I have all of my TSM groups right here, which before was in a side section like this. If I wanted to actually deal with any of my groups, now they're all condensed right away. They're available to me right away. If I wanted to actually do any of my favorite searches before, yes, they're on the side window over here. Now they're conveniently located on your left columns right here. As you type stuff into here, notice that it'll actually do the searching. And then when you go back to save searches, it's up here, right clicking, still adds it and removes it from your favorite searches. Which is very cool because you can do faster searches right away from groups or from here without going through different tabs. And then of course favorite searches is there, and then of course when you click on custom filter, you have the same functionality, but instead of having the side window to your right, everything is consolidated right here. So your other searches, your vendoring, your disenchant, your sniper searching, as well as your custom filtering, which was a separate window completely, just like on the side over here, is now conveniently located in your optimized TradeSkillMaster version 3 window. So that's one of the major changes that you're going to see. That covers that. Same type of searching functionality for crafting as well as normal. Those features are still there from a UI standpoint. It does have these rollover things now that actually gives you some information. They're kind of using the World of Warcraft tooltips features that you have that, which is populated in all the different sections that you want to go to. Hover your mouse over it, it makes it a little bit more instructional and easy to read. Easy to kind of find your way through what's going on. Underneath the auction and tab, same type of functionality that's dealt before. Again, everything is actually optimized. It's not over in a side corner. And then as you start searching in functions, the functionality is the same way, whether you're deselecting groups, whether you're doing certain searches or not, select all, deselect, start, post, scan, cancel, reset, all of those features are actually still there and still available for you. Again, the cool thing about auctioning now comes with this quick post from Bags, which, tell you the truth, is unbelievable for people who actually think that TradeSkillMaster 2 is complex or hard to set up or there's a steep learning curve. This function, it will be heavenly for you because it will actually put you in the driving seat of a powerful TradeSkillMaster auctioning feature right off the bat without knowing any structures. In fact, I'll show you that later on in a later video where I'll actually change my profile. Notice here is actually all my groups. I will change my profile to actually be now one of them that has zero groups. And I'll show you actually posting with zero groups in TradeSkillMaster version 3 and making gold that way, which is incredible. So ladies and gentlemen, that is actually the features and the major UI changes for TradeSkillMaster version 3. I hope you enjoyed this video. There will be more videos coming out covering the more in-depth features of the changes for each of the sections. So don't worry, this is just a high-level UI glimpse of some of the awesome features coming down the road for you in TradeSkillMaster version 3. So thank you very much, guys. I'm Profitz from Profitz.tv. Hope you guys enjoy the day. Take care. Happy gaming. More importantly, happy earning.